Hi everyone, this is Rajeshwari, who is working as assistant professor at St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we would like to deal with this lesson writing called writing skills. So writing skills, actually we all need writing skills in our daily life. Writing skills plays a major role in everybody's life. Even suppose good writing skills allows you to communicate with ease and clarity to audience far larger than telephone conversations, even face-to-face conversations. Apart from workplace, you need good writing skills, even if you want to join any university or college also. So good grammar, punctuation, clarity are the key roles in writing skills. Suppose if you want to write a research paper or journal, you need good writing skills, and those are even reports or resume or cover letter also. So those are need careful structuring and writing also. So first of all, we see why writing skills are important. Writing skills are important because they need 2 points. So across rather than physical content. So actually, professional writing skills are a complex process. So we need different skills like planning, editing, and writing marks. So we need writing skills will play a major role in everybody's life. So first of all, we will see in writing skills, we'll go with the resume writing and cover letter. Resume writing, first of all, what is resume? Resume is the individual background of a person. It gives the background of a person, his education, his professional experience, his skills, achievements, honors, everything. If you want to know the background of a person, you should see his resume. Actually, when you want to write a resume, you need to keep in mind 2 things. First one is the employers or recruiters, they search your resume, they use special software, they search your resume with keywords. So first of all, when we make a resume, so we have generally any resume contains 5 topics. Those are, first one is contact information. So generally we have in any resume contact information, position chart, professional summary, professional experience, skills, honors, your achievements. So we need to include all these 5 topics in your resume. First we will deal with the contact information. When you write contact information in your resume, you need to write your address, email ID, phone number, clarity, and you have to use bold letters and font size larger than the rest. So when you mention contact information, you need to write email ID also. When you write email ID, you have to write all your alternate email IDs. So you have to create one professional email ID also. So first of all, and one more thing, when you mention address, you need to write the place where you are living in, even your area and state also you have to mention. So you should be aware of your contact information should be in bold and it's not should be in the header. And next we will deal with the position chart. If you are applying any job, so first of all you have to mention what type of position you need, so that the other the employer and interviewer can distinguish between the two. Those who might have applied any other positions in the company, he can distinguish the resumes. So next, third one is professional experience. Skills also, what do you want to achieve in your life? Goal also you have to mention in your career criteria objective, it should be minimum 2 or 3 lines. You have to mention enumerate it. And the fourth one is your professional summary. When you write your resume, your professional summary includes your skills. What if you have any special skills, you have to mention in your professional summary. Even educational qualifications which related that skills also you have to mention in your professional summary. And the fifth one is we have professional experience. When you write resume, your professional experience, you should follow one format. First, whenever you write your professional experience, you have to jot down one by one. You have to first write the company name and place you work in the company name must be updated, and the date and mention. You have to follow the month and the year also, and experience also, including months, you have to mention in your professional experience. And next one is skills. When you write resume, you have to mention skills also. Suppose if you completed BTech or if you completed any MBA or MA, MSc, whatever it is, you have to mention. When you mention skills, suppose if you completed BTech, you need to mention your technical skills. So technical skills, when you mention technical skills, suppose first you have to mention languages. So languages, suppose if you want to mention languages, C or C++, suppose Java. So if whatever you, maybe some students there, some of us may be familiar with C, C++. So which language you are familiar with? Just mention first one C. Suppose if you are familiar with C, I will mention C only. In order we have to mention all these. And coming to database also. Database you have to write whatever you have. Database like Python and whatever it is. Now database also coming to technical skills only Python and whatever you have you skills in order you have to mention whichever you are familiar with you mention in database also. Office. So office generally all we have bar we know MS Office. If you have to mention MS Office also. And next coming to the achievements. Achievements. Suppose when you are studying your BTech or MBA or MBA, maybe we have so many achievements during our experience also. You have to mention if you have any achievements and even honors, any rewards, anything you have to mention in the achievement section. And one more thing, we have differences. References. Suppose if you know any person from a particular company, you have to mention in the reference section. Reference section is those who knows your work, those who know your work experience. You have to mention their name in reference section. Actually, in resume, these are all contained. These are all consists of in the resume. And one more thing, we have different types of resumes also. Depend on the arrangement of the resumes, we have 3 types of resumes. First one is chronological resume. Chronological resume, we have in chronological resume, it is based on the experience only. So first of all, generally we mention in resume, so all these 5 topics, contact information, professional summary, education, achievements, honors, all these we mention. So a chronological resume takes important on only experience section. So all these we will mention, skills will give less importance in chronological resume. So whereas second one, functional and combinational resume. Functional and combinational resume. So these two are different from chronological resume. Functional resume we will use it as a skill based resume. We will use only skills only. And combinational resume. So So we use both. We have to combine chronological and the functional. If you combine both the resume skills as well as experience, if you combine it, we can make it as a combinational resume. So whenever you make resume, you have to. Whenever you make resume, you have to follow proofreading and a good format. Good, you have to make good document also. So first, next we will see the cover letter. Actually, we have the different formats coming to all the formal letters or informal letters. We have the formats, but coming to cover letter, especially when you appear for jobs, job applications, job cover letters, there is no format, there is no special format for cover letters. Generally, I can give some clues how to prepare for cover letter. So when you write cover letter, you have to mention right side address. When you mention address, you just follow the margins also. When you mention address, you have to write clarity. You have to make what we call write clarity. First, you write your address, write your name and your area, all these things. Even where you live in, where which state you are living, mention clearly in other section. And coming to the left, you mention two address. So suppose if you know the person's name, you can mention Mrs. Saxena. Suppose if you don't know the person, you need not mention. Suppose you mention their designation to the HR manager, TCS Madhapur. So you mention like this. And one more thing. And when you mention after this, you have to mention salutation. Salutation also you have to mention, respected sir. So this is actually whenever we write letter, respected sir or dear sir, dear sir or dear madam, depend on the letter, whether it is formal or informal, we will write the salutations. Salutation you write down, respected sir, and comma also you have to put down. And after that you need to write under this only, you need to write first paragraph. And write down the subject. I'm going to apply the so and so question you write down, so that the employer will be he will get one idea by seeing your subject. After that, you underneath this only you write one body, first introduction paragraph. Underneath this only, introduction paragraph you write down, introduction section you write down, how do you know about this, vacancy. So you have to mention in introduction section. Introduction section, you write down, suppose all of us we know through the papers, with reference to papers, otherwise with reference to any website, with reference to the friends, all these you can mention in introduction section. And coming to education and qualification, suppose if you complete BTech, MBA, MBA or MBA, whatever it is, mention in educational qualifications. So next paragraph should be, achievements and goals. Whatever achievements, maybe we have good experience, so that through your experience you can mention your achievements, goals, whatever goals you have, you can mention. If you have any honors, any rewards also you can mention in achievement section. And the next one, thank you for giving this so and so job. All these you can mention in the thank you section also. After that, you can write down thank you also. After that, you can write down thank you. Okay. Underneath this right side, you have to write complimentary clause. So write down the thank you also, thank you, comma. And you write down right side, respectfully, comma. This is called actually in letter writing complimentary clause. Underneath it, you can can write your name and sign us. So this is actually a cover letter. Generally, we write in job sections. So thank you very much.